I saw something that year I ain't ever seen before or since. I'd call it animal. Except animals only kill for food. This was Sioux Falls. Ever been?
Went to Sioux City once, back in my scandalous days.
The Coen brothers are masters of subtlety and unpredictability. Their films focus heavily on life's real spontaneity. Their stories don't always end happily or sad, they usually end with random or unexpected outcomes. Most of the time, events portrayed in their films end abruptly without explanation, or indeed justifying their conclusion. I could sit and talk about the hundreds of little ideas embedded within the Coen brothers universe, but today we're going to focus on a rather unusual concept placed within the world of Fargo. Adapted from the critically acclaimed 1996 black comedy by Joel and Ethan Coen, Fargo's transition to television by Noah Hawley was met with an overwhelmingly positive reception, with the Coens serving as executive producers. It told its own original and morally complex tale and continued the Coens' trademark style, further solidifying the universe they have spent the last 30 years crafting. But something very striking about season 2 was the inclusion of an unexplained UFO. Now, in a world centered around gritty realism, true crime, the spontaneous nature of life, and authenticity, the use of extraterrestrial themes has certainly bridged the gap between true reality and total fantasy. Well, not exactly, because you see, the UFO is in fact part of this real world. Yes, without a doubt, the UFO is a physical entity and does undeniably exist. Every character is completely aware of the UFO's presence, and Peggy even brushes it off as if it's an ordinary occurrence in the regular world. More importantly, it even has a direct influence on the outcome of events. Its appearance led to the death of two Gerhardt brothers. Ray is dazzled by its appearance after he murders a diner full of innocent people, which abruptly leads to him being hit by Peggy's car. Bear, on the other hand, is distracted by it during a motel shootout, allowing Lou to get his gun on time to kill Bear before he's choked to death. Its impact on the story is rather significant. Without the UFO distraction, Lou would surely have died, but more crucially, Ray would not have been hit by Peggy's car. Thus, the chain of events that followed would not have happened. With the sudden death of Ray sparks a domino effect of events that result in the deaths of many people. So it isn't Peggy to blame for the chaos that transpires, but rather, it's the UFO that's to blame. Its appearance has certainly caused some rather confused and conflicted responses for many viewers, which I hope to alleviate or at the very least clarify to some degree. The original Fargo, and even more presently in each episode of the television counterpart, it begins with the disclaimer that the story is completely true, and it's told exactly as it were. This is in fact not the case, the story is completely fictional. In the case of the Coens, Fargo is an amalgamation of several real crimes. By calling it a true story, Joel Coen argues that anything they do in the narrative world is more likely to be accepted as fact. It's a manipulation tactic that's actually quite common in many modern horror movies to get the audience to accept anything that would otherwise be deemed unbelievable or implausible, like a UFO. In the case of season 2, the UFO is undeniable. It is in fact part of the real story. It isn't a stylized metaphor or psychological in any way, so those thinking it's all in the character's head might need to take a rain check. In an interview with Entertainment Weekly, series showrunner Noah Hawley even confirmed its existence. Hawley argued that it played well within the conspiracy-minded 1979 era, where it's post-Watergate, you had Close Encounters and Star Wars. If you watched my previous video on the history of the X-Files, link in the description, you'll know that Richard Nixon's Watergate scandal resulted in increased public paranoia, and reinforced the public's distrust and skepticism towards the government. UFO sightings and alleged alien abductions ran rampant in 1970s America, including Travis Walton, Charles Hickson and Calvin Parker, the Wehner brothers, Charles Volst and Charles Reck, and most notably by Holly, the Val Johnson case in 1979, the same year and location that Fargo's second season takes place. Val Johnson was a Minnesota deputy sheriff, who claimed to have encountered a UFO which caused him to go unconscious following an intense beam of light that shot towards him at 2 in the morning. Many of these encounters, whether they be true or just a hoax, sparked mass curiosity in the subject matter, and inevitably led to UFOlogy becoming a more prominent area of scientific inquiry, because government spending is not unjustified whatsoever. I'm very inclined to agree with Holly's point because the use of UFOs fit well within the mindset of the time period, and the paranoia of the unknown was certainly prevalent. When Peggy dismisses the UFO's existence, she's probably become desensitized by its coverage in the mass media, poking fun of the unhealthy obsession that people had with aliens. Furthermore, it's important to understand that you shouldn't overthink the UFO's existence. One reason for Fargo's success on television is Holly's faithfulness to the Coen brothers' style and philosophy. As Holly states, in actual history, there's a lot that we understand, and there's a lot that we'll never understand. This is a very Coen brother belief. Some things just happen and we'll never exactly know why they just happened. It's a phenomenon. It doesn't have to correlate with the story. For example, we expect a villain to get a dramatic death. But who's to say that they can't just unexpectedly have a heart attack during the story rather than at the end? The UFO is a challenging concept for anyone to be convinced by, but all these real-life allegations are never validated. We assume them to be preposterous because we look at the world with a very narrow-minded rationale. If it defies common sense, then we disbelieve in its existence. Holly even justifies the writing of Fargo as being a reflective experience. So much storytelling, especially on television, is a spoon-fed experience with clarity of all things. This is something that the Coens are quite against. Very few of their films clarify information. We, as the audience, are so used to having all the answers, that when we're confronted by the reality that not everything in life will be explained to us, it leaves us in existential doubt and disillusionment. In the Coens' 2001 black and white noir, The Man Who Wasn't There, when Ed awaits execution, he goes out into the prison yard to reflect on his life, when he witnesses a UFO in the night sky. It has no significance to it, but rather Ed simply accepts it as one of life's unexpected mysteries, and goes inside to be put to death. It's a very morbid point, I know, but it's mixed with an oddly dark sense of humor to reinforce the point that we're not all going to go out knowing all the answers. As I said at the beginning of the video, the Coens have a very cynical outlook with their stories, and most of their films unfold with unexpected and almost random occurrences. The events of The Big Lebowski unfold with irrelevancy. Death in No Country for Old Men is seemingly abrupt, Inside Llewyn Davis and Burn After Reading lack resolution, and the conflicts of A Serious Man are washed away by the unpredictable force of nature. As Holly declares, we must accept the mystery. We shouldn't search for clarity or reasoning because that's part of our existence, accepting things that we don't know and probably never will know. Closure doesn't always exist. The short answer for why the UFO exists in Fargo is much like what I just explained. It doesn't have to have a reason to exist, it's just unquestionably there, and you're just going to have to accept that this is simply just fact. Hi guys, thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please share your own thoughts, comments, theories, suggestions, whatever it may be below the video. And also, if you haven't already, please do hit that little subscribe button. Next week, we're going to be talking about The Walking Dead. So until then, stay safe and I'll see you next Thursday.